similar to what the goal for this event is, really just to facilitate between the public and officials. And we also want to create a list of prioritized actions that we could recommend to some of our local officials, and that maybe we could also take on ourselves. There were over 100 people in attendance that day, including affected residents and concerned neighbors, including people in Faulkner County, and even we had people come down from Oklahoma, and we were seeing people there from Florida. So it was pretty good crowd. We had environmental and health experts that we flew in from out of state. Really good to have them there. And there's a lot of local and state officials and several media outlets that covered the event. There were presentations on various topics, including the evaluation of available data, which came straight from ADEQ's website. We had an environmental scientist go over some of the available data and break that down for us. And actually, there's a handout in front of you that outlines that. Also, there were the associated health concerns were discussed pretty in-depth at the first town hall meeting. Glenn Hook from Sierra Club, who's going to be here later today, talked about community mobilization. We also had a good talk about rights after an oil spill, which we're going to talk more about today. And then we talked a lot about the Exxon Valdez and BP disaster and how it compares to Maine Farm. We also released the results of independent air and water testing, which we are going to be releasing some more independent water samples dated today. And then we made a list of recommended actions, which I'll go over now. There were 12 recommended actions that folks in the audience recommended, and then they were voted on. So this is, they're prioritized. So the one on top here is the one that got the most support from the crowd. And these recommendations were delivered to City Planning Committee in Mayflower, the City Council, the County Judge, the Senators in this district, Congressman Griffin, and several other officials. So the first recommended action was for Arkansas to buy Optlex for the best available technology to clean up the oil that still remains in the water, and also to do complete comprehensive water column testing. And thanks to Scott Smith, who's continuing to do that. We're going to hear from him later today. Also, the second most popular recommended action was a comprehensive community health assessment. This has got to be done, and we're hoping the health department can step up and do this. We also recommended to form a qualified settlement trust, which David Lincoln from Sierra Club will be talking about later today, too. Also, we wanted to request the pipeline integrity report from 2011 that was performed by Exxon. Also, there was one performed in 2013 in February, just a month before the spill, that we would like to see the results of those reports before the pipeline is allowed to be turned back on. Also, another big one is we need to educate the community on health risks. This is a big deal. And unfortunately, our state agencies are really not taking a proactive role in doing this. So it's up to community members, it's up to students in the local universities and high schools. And we're hoping to get LAPC, which is the Local Emergency Planning Committee, Office of Emergency Management, to do these types of things. We also talked about, in the future, having a mobile wildlife response unit. The Hawk Center was a really key player right after the spill in getting some of the wildlife that was affected and treating them and releasing them back into the wild. Unfortunately, they were taken off the case about a week after the spill, and Exxon took that over. So, unfortunately, one of the things we discussed is that these incidents are going to be happening more and more in Arkansas. Pipeline ruptures and pollution events that are going to cause effects to the wildlife. So we need to establish some type of mobile wildlife unit now to prepare for those future events. The other recommended actions were to do a permanent assessment of the ecosystem. That's something that we're hoping Game and Fish, ADEQ will do. We're certainly in contact with those agencies to encourage those and to support them in that. Also, we want to make it law that first responders and anyone who's working to clean up the oil spill has proper respiration and proper respirators, because this stuff, as most of you know, is extremely highly toxic. And a few days after the spill, several of the members of our group were in Mayflower documenting, taking pictures right there in the middle of the cleanup. And we did even see a handful of folks that had proper respirators on. About dozens and dozens of men and women who were being exposed to really high levels of really terrible material. And that is just absolutely appalling to us. So it needs to be made into law, which it probably already is, but then you can enforce it. The suggestion that I made was actually to put flags or some type of physical marker in the community where the air testing is showing high high levels of harmful chemicals. That way, you can avoid those areas. You can actually see a physical marker. Also, get involved. You know, we talked a lot about a movetoamend.org, which is has to do with the corporate citizenship and corporations are people. We tend to disagree that corporations are people. So there's a website you can go to and kind of read a little bit more information about that. Another big one that is really important that we're hoping to try to get implemented is to get specialized occupational and environmental medicine doctors to come to these local clinics and train the local doctors on how to treat these patients with chemical exposure and to not be treating them with regular pharmaceuticals or antibiotics. This is really super critical, and maybe during our Q&A, April, who's sitting right there, can talk maybe a little bit more about that because she's been in contact with some of those folks. And then the last one actually didn't come out of this town hall, but it was something that the members of SCCAU talked about afterwards, and we really want to get some type of community action council or some type of group of Mayflower residents who are willing to take up the cause for themselves and to make their own group that is specific to Mayflower that they can kind of take up town halls and start to have their own meetings like this. So, again, all these recommended actions are delivered to several officials, and we're certainly happy to keep doing what we're doing at SCCAG and we plan to keep doing town halls like this. We really want to encourage, especially the people who are here from Mayflower, to really help us help you. And I did have one more slide, I'm sorry. Of course, another result of our first town hall was it inspired this one. We're really glad to be here today, and we really thank all of you for being here, and I'll be around later for questions if you want to ask me. And right now, David is going to come up, and I'll let him introduce himself, because he's better at it than I am, probably. Okay.
We'll be right back.
Sierra Club, and when I was here a month ago, I was pretty angry with Exxon and the kind of things that they have done, but now that I have had a chance to study the details and really look into the approach that they used, now I'm really mad.